Americans. Was it because of a protest, or was it because of guys out for a walk one night who decided they'd go kill some Americans? What difference at this point does it make?
And I look forward to continuing this dialogue in the months ahead. Thank you very much, everybody.
Everyone, welcome to Wake Up America. My name is Phil Marie. We got Wally K.
Hi.
And it's time, Wally, to wake up America. Last week, real quick, we had a special guest on the phone. Last week we were here live show. I don't know what happened, but we were here with Lori Hopkins, and they're gonna air it after this show. So you guys get 2 hours of us, right, Wally? 2 hours of us. But Barrie Trower, we spoke about Barrie Trower and showed many, many videos of him. And he's going to be on the phone with us for 1 hour or 50 minutes or even less than that, 45 minutes. And I'm going to get to ask him some questions. And that's probably about it, Wally. This isn't working right with a laptop and the computer either, so I can't take emails like I wanted to with questions. So that's the way technology works. But anyways, hello, Barrie. Are you there?
I'm here, sir. Yes.
Thank you. We're on the air, and my viewers have seen your videos for the last year and a half. I've showed them several different videos, and they are aware of who you are and so forth. And it's an honor to have you on for the whole show tonight.
It's my pleasure, sir. It really is my pleasure.
Great. If you could, Barrie, maybe just, if you could start out, like in this situation where I've been a targeted person, just real briefly, I just want to run through this in case there's any new viewers watching tonight. Okay, I'm gonna run through what happened to me in 2007. I applied to a game show for NBC, which was owned by GE, General Electric, that makes a lot of these weapons. Electronics, what have you. I became stalked in the summer of 2007, organized stalking, and then in the fall of 2007, I began getting shocks to my body, microwave pulses to all parts of my body. That continued on until February of 2008, when I ended up with a serious migraines, ringing of the ears. I had a mini stroke. They put me in the hospital. The nurses were sticking their heads in the door, looking at me, calling me evil or saying the word evil. It was the most horrible situation. I fled my house. My house was bugged in New Hampshire also. So basically, GE had a lot to do with what had happened in my situation. So I just wanted to lay that out, Barrie. Anything you want to add to that?
Everything you have described, I've heard many, many times before, sir, in many, many other countries. It is a standard technique for harassment and targeting people.
Now, right now, I guess my concern is, as a person that's constantly hit, like all day I've been hit pretty hard since this morning when you were on the air with Lee Elsie on 94.9, all day I've been getting shocks, all different parts of the body, and I have like a grounding effect. It feels like my feet are grounding out, are like shorting out to the ground. What causes that?
Well, this will happen. It's just not people. It happens to animals as well. If you are microwaved, the microwaves will go into the body and pass right through the body. They will also set up a current within the body. And any current within the body will have to be grounded. It's like a minuscule electric shock. Now, if for some reason the current cannot leave the body, the soles of your shoes are rubber or something, if the current cannot leave the body, then it builds up and up and up. And it is known with horses and cattle that there are occasions when they are near transmitters, ordinary transmitters, as soon as their wet noses touch a metal gate, the current is discharged through them, and they will have a spontaneous abortion or heart attack and just drop dead on the spot. And any other cattle touching them will also die. And it can be the same with humans. The current will build up and up and up, and it will discharge through the body as and when it can. In fact, a rather clever gentleman when I was in one of the European countries said, if you're being targeted, one really good thing to do is walk bare feet on preferably damp grass for 20 minutes a day and really just discharge your body from all of the charge which is building up.
You know, that's something I've never heard or read, and I've done a lot of research, obviously, in the last 6 years to try to find any angles of comfort, you know? And so I will try that. I also heard of a guy that worked in the electrical field that he used to go into the salt water occasionally to do a similar thing. Is that correct?
Well, water is a very good electrical conductor. Water stores charge. So, I mean, if you were to sit with your feet in water, it would take the charge, basically, from your feet. The charge builds up in the body, and when it comes through the body, it takes the path of least resistance, as all electric currents do. But the problem is the path of least resistance in the body, although it only constitutes about 10% of the pathways in the body, it carries about 90% of the most important traffic, namely the neurotransmitters, the hormones, the antibodies, and they search for the parts of the body they want, if I put it crudely, because of minuscule electric currents on their outside, and they know where to get off in the body, rather like if you're on an underground or a bus and you're following a map. When this current is discharging through the body, it can change the electrical signals on the neurotransmitters, and this, of course, can affect everything in the body from epilepsy right down to your big toe.
Now, this morning on Lee Elsie's show, you mentioned that the biochemical elements are changed in the body, and that it takes a long time to recover, and that there is possibly a way of me proving that I've been hit with microwaves. Is that correct?
Oh, absolutely, sir. I mean, there are pages upon pages of chemical changes in the body. I'm currently making a list of the most important ones because it is possible to prove that you are being targeted. And I can give an instance, if you like.
Yes.
If I just talk about, it's just like a few of the main chemicals in the brain. If I talk about anandamide, enkephalin, orexin, a very delicate balance between the frontal cortex and the ventral pallidum, the frontal cortex and the amygdala. Now, those parts of the brain, they will distribute, when they are required by the body, the equivalent of morphine, marijuana, absolute hunger to the point where you will steal for food, absolute hopelessness, where really all you want to do is die, and absolute severe aggression. Now, those chemicals which can be produced, they require an electrical current in the brain of about 2 milliamps. When you're exposed to microwave irradiation from a cell phone, or especially if you're in a car, the current generated in the brain can be up to 14 times that amount. Now, it doesn't mean that you're going to get 14 times those chemicals, because the body can't produce them, but it does mean you can get some of them. And once those chemicals are released in the brain, now you have chemical changes going on in the molecular structure, and that is traceable, and with that can be tested for experimentally in a laboratory, and it can show up in the blood, it can show up in the tissues, it can show up in the bones. So if you know what you're looking for, you can prove that you are being targeted, and you can prove that you have been targeted, provided specimens are kept and you are within a sort of a safe limit time of looking for them.
Now, I've also experienced that some of the medical field, along with law enforcement, participate in this targeting. So, I guess, how do you know who to trust? Who you can trust? Who's honest?
Oh, that is such a good question, sir. And the honest answer is, you do not. You will never, ever know who you can trust. And I will tell you why. Sometimes a university department will do some work, and it will be brilliant work, sort of Nobel Prize genius type work. And they will do it quite innocently, believing they are helping people who are mentally sick, physically disabled, mentally disabled. And once they have done this, then the military will come along, or the government will come along and use it on a different part of the body for a different purpose. Virtually anything which is done for good can be turned for bad. So the scientist who has developed this is not necessarily bad. It may be the government scientist who has come along and decided to use it elsewhere. And a good example of this is, of course, Agent Orange, which the United States used in Vietnam. I mean, it was designed to stop plant growth, but another scientist came along and decided that you could spray it across people, or if people ate the crops, it could then cause abortions, spontaneous abortions, that is, miscarriages, genetically damaged children, and they're still suffering to this day. So you really don't know who you can trust, because some scientists are doing work for good, others come along and change it, and of course there are scientists, and I have come across them, who from the very outset will follow any government order, any government request, and they will experiment on anybody, provided they are well paid and they, you know, get their just rewards. So, you know, you have pure good and pure evil, like a seesaw motion here.